Hey guys, what's up? Roman here from Tech Guides, and today we're going to continue with our home server tutorial video series. So today's video is going to be about integrating IP cameras with your home server. And more specifically for this video, Realink was very kind to provide a RLC810A IP camera. This is a great 4K IP camera, which is super easy to set up. I will do a full in-depth review of this camera in a few months' time, but I want to give myself a few months of operation and experience with this camera to actually see how it performs in the long run. But for now, I'm actually really happy. Setting this up was actually a breeze. Just plug it into a router or a modem or a Wi-Fi adapter through a power over Ethernet injector, and this thing is running. Also, if you're interested, you can find a link to this camera in the description below. So with that, let's look at what we actually want to achieve in today's video. So we do have an IP camera somewhere set up in our home network, and now we want to capture a snapshot of this live stream, do some image processing with Image Magic, for instance, adding some annotations and also cropping the image to a smaller file size, and then archiving this image every, say, 5 minutes. Now, what will you need in order to be able to follow along with this video? So first of all, you'll need a home server, which preferably is running Ubuntu, as I have set it up in this previous video. And then you'll also need an IP camera, which is already up and running in the same network as your home server. But with having said that, let's hop right into the video. And the first part of today's video is going to be how to access the live feed of your Realink webcam through a browser. So the first thing you want to do is to add a new user, which then only has access to this image and cannot actually change any of the settings of the webcam. So for this, let's click on the cog icon, go to System, User Management, and let's add a new user. And this user can only change their password, but they cannot change device settings. So that's what we want. Let's call this server, give him a pretty simple password. Let's save the user. So in order to access the live feed of our Realink webcam, we can browse to this very handy support documentation here on the Realink website that gives us the URL that we need to use in order to create a snapshot of the current live feed. So to use this, you have to enter the local IP address under which your Realink webcam is listed. So in my case, this would be 192.168.1.115. And then this is the URL. It will use channel 0, which is the one with the highest possible quality. The RS is a random string or number combination. You can put anything here. And this was actually something that I was a bit confused about, what I should put here, but you can just put anything here. And then followed by the user. So this is the user that we just created, which is server, as well as the password, which is secret Ubuntu in our case. And now you realize why we wanted to create a new user that only has access to essentially viewing the image. And the reason is that we have to type the password in clear text into a file or into the browser. But because we generated a new unprivileged user that really has no access onto our webcam other than being able to retrieve the image, this really doesn't pose a security issue in my opinion. Now, if this happens, then you probably have misspelled either your username or password. And I can already tell you that I mistyped secret Ubuntu. And just like that, you have access to the latest image taken by your webcam. Pretty neat. Back on our home server, we might be tempted to simply use the wget command in order to download content from a website onto our home server. However, if you try to do the wget followed by the IP address of your home server, as well as the URL that we just typed into the browser, you can see that wget kind of crashes, or it just goes into an infinite loop. It doesn't stop anymore. It tells us that it's redirecting output to wget log, but it never really finishes. So you can cancel this by pressing Control Z. And as you can see, the wget log doesn't really contain any useful information. So in order to in fact download the webcam image from this URL, we have to modify the wget command a little bit. So we're gonna have to enter wget followed by dash capital O. So rewrite the output from the website into a file.
we will call this raw image.jpg, followed by the no HTTP keep alive flag. And this is relevant because the webcam apparently isn't able to transfer the image over the same TCP connection. So the image is obviously transferred in multiple steps, and this makes wget kind of trip. So we need this flag followed by the URL of the webcam image inside of quotes. Et voila, if you hit enter, you can see that the webcam image is finally being downloaded onto our home server. We can use MobileXTerm, which is another application that you can use to connect to SSH servers, to preview the image. And as you can see, the webcam transfer has successfully worked.
So with this wget command, you are now able to retrieve the current live feed of your webcam on your home server. Of course, this in itself isn't really going to help you at all. So we're going to have to also set up a script that allows you to retrieve this image in a certain interval, for instance, every 5 minutes. Then we also want to do some image processing, and we also want to archive the image into different directories corresponding to the date when the image has been taken.
So for this, I prepared a little shell script called webcam.sh that, by the way, you can download either on my blog or on my GitHub page. And contained within this script are some commands that essentially retrieves the raw image, adds some weather information and does some resizing, and then finally saves the image into an archive. So let me walk through the different parts of this shell script. So first we have the shebang for bash. So essentially this tells the operating system which interpreter to use for this file, in this case bash. And first I'm reading two files from disk. Note that this is very specific to what I'm doing here on my home server. So I'm using a specific application that generates an overlay and an update file. And when we look at the contents of these files, we can see that they contain some weather information in text form, as well as when this information was updated. So for simplicity's sake, you could also think of these as just being two strings, overlay test one, and then update test two. Next, we'll retrieve the current date and time. Now, in order to save the output of a specific command into another variable, we can simply use this notation here. So a variable equals dollar opening bracket, then the command, followed by a closing bracket. In the next step, we retrieve the raw image using the wget command that we've just discussed. Note, however, that I slightly modified the RS arguments here, such that it will always use the latest time, meaning that this will always use a different token whenever this is executed. So this will write the current live feed of our webcam into the raw underscore image.jpg. Next, we'll use convert from image magic in order to convert our raw image into a smaller version of itself. And then we'll add a whole bunch of different fillers and annotations on top of our image. So first, let's have a look at the output of this. So the first thing we want to do is we want to add a black or sort of opaque banner at the bottom of our image, which we can then use as a background for text, watermarks, and date overlays. So this argument provides the black rectangle at the bottom of the image. Then we add the overlay text. So this is the one, in this case now, our test one, followed by the update text. In this case, it would be test two, as well as a third text, which is just the website where I'm providing this webcam image through at these specific annotation locations. The other arguments are pretty self-explanatory. We'll use the Nimbus Sans font, white fill, and use an interline spacing of 13. Note that this is relevant because our overlay text actually has two lines of text, which you can produce by providing a text string that contains a backslash n at the location where we want to have a line break. And finally, the result of all of these manipulations are saved into a current.jpg file. Now, if we have just created this file, this webcam.shell, and we want to execute it, then you'll get a permission denied, and you can get around this either by typing bash webcam.shell or by changing the mode to 775, which then allows you to execute the file using this notation. As you can see, the wget command is able to download or retrieve the live view of the Relink webcam, and it saves the file into rawimage.jpg. And if you switch over to MobileXterm, we can see that we have also generated two more images, the current JPEG and current small. So let's have a look at the current JPEG. And as you can see, we now have exactly what we put into our file. We have the test, line break test, and test 2 on the right hand side, as well as the URL of my website. Let's open up the shell script once again. Exchange these random strings here again with the actual text files that we want to overlay. Save the file, execute it. And as you can see, now the current weather information is overlaid. Now let's see what else we have in this shell script. The last part now generates a small preview. So we'll use ImageMagix convert method again to convert the raw image into a resized smaller current small.jpg. And in the final section, we archive the current webcam image into an archive structure. So first we generate the directory structure using makedir. Now it's important that we use the p flag, which generates nested directories, but only if they don't exist, in order for this not to throw an error if the directory already exists, under year, month, and day. And we then simply copy the current JPEG, so the current image with all of these overlays here, into the year, month, day directory, followed by some random string. So this is just the file name, and you can name this whatever you want, but you probably want to have some prefix followed by year, month, day, underscore hour, minute, dot JPEG. Now, if you browse into the 2022 folder, January, the 9th of January, we can see that last time that I executed a script, which was at 12:36, we generated a file that is called Relink year month day 12:36. And if you open this file, we can see, yeah, well, this makes sense. We have updated the data from our weather station at 12:36. So this is essentially all what you need in order to retrieve the image from your Relink webcam, do some image manipulation, and save the image into an archive directory. Now, obviously, in a last step, what we want to do is to add a cron job to our web server, which executes this script, for instance, every 5 minutes. To do this, we can type cron tab dash e, and then we can add a cron tab. Let's say I want this to run every 5 minutes. And then we want to execute the script, which in my case lies under home roman relink webcam.shell. So with this cron job, we should in fact see a new image being generated in our archive folder every 5 minutes. As you can see, this isn't quite the case. And the reason for this is actually pretty simple. It's because the cron job user is executed not in the Relink folder, but actually in the home folder of the respective user that has started the cron job. We can verify this. As you can see, the current and the raw image file have been written into the home directory of the user that has started the cron job, rather than into the Relink folder where we actually want these files to reside within. Now, we could either not really care because the script still works and it also generates us a nice archive here. But if we want to fix this, what we can do is to simply go back into our shell script and start the script with a change directory directive and specifying the folder within which we want to execute this script. And that's it. If we now save the file and wait for another 5 minutes, then we should see the images to start popping up in our Relink folder. And that's it for today's video, guys. I hope with this video you are now also able to set up your own webcam archive on your home server. Once again, I'd like to thank Relink for providing the RLC 810A. You can find this webcam linked in the description below. But if you still have any questions or something isn't running quite as it should, then definitely leave me a comment down below. Like this video if you liked it, subscribe for more Linux and home server related tutorials like the one you're watching right now. Thank you guys so much for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.